Hey friends, welcome back to the homestead. We are in the throes of our redbud winter. And I'm not happy about it. Springtime comes along and teases us with her nice warm weather, and then it drops down below freezing again. But that's okay. It does mean that warmer weather is on the horizon, which also means that we need to get some things ready for it, including getting the tractor ready and the bush hog ready. And we're going to be replacing some slip discs on the PTO for the bush hog. Now, this is something that I've never done before, so we're going to be learning together. But don't worry, I've watched half a YouTube video on it, so we should be in good shape. What this is, these are just some clutch pads that go in the PTO so that as the PTO is spinning, if the bush hog gets caught up on something, it will slip on this disc and kind of act as a protection from breaking your PTO. We picked up this bush hog. It was used and abused, but still working really well, except that the slip clutch had been tightened down so that it wouldn't slip, and they stuck shear pins in it as a fix, because that's often what we homesteaders do, is we just fix things in the moment and then we never get around to the actual fix for it. We've got the PTO shaft here connected to the slip clutch. This part just spins around inside there. We've got all of our springs off there. Had some fun times with our bolts, but we managed to persuade them to come off. I think we'll just slice those off with the cutting wheel and then tap them bolts out with a hammer. I think that'll be the best course of action to come up with here. So now I need a punch and a hammer. Ow, that's hot.
Yeah. It's nice to have the right tools.
Well, I couldn't find the right punch, but I think I got something that'll work.
Tap, tap.
Yeah,
Now I've got all that cut off.
Oh, look how easy that came off.
Super easy. Wow. Man, that wasn't difficult at all. The old pad right there. Yep. Like this whole thing is supposed to just slide off. Let me look and see what I got to make that happen. Why can't homesteading be easy? It was only held on there by like a 3/4 of an inch, yeah. Half an inch. But that was on there tight. My goodness. We got it. Now I just gotta get those bolts out of there, put it all back together. Yep, all right. So we've got these guys out of there. All the rusted bolts, plates, all come off. And then this part, which was a pain in the butt. So now we just need to clean up all the rust so it's a little smoother, and then we can try to put it all back together. I didn't want to take off material. right here. All right. So now we put a spring on here. We grab a big fat bolt. I mean a nut to go on the bolt.
Knees bothering me today for some reason.
Why are your knees bothering you?
I don't know. It's just, I think I ate supper with Tim Benson. All he complained about is getting old.
All right. It's embarrassing.
Okay.
But it's together. So what we'll do is we'll take this, put it over there on the tractor or on the bush hog, and then see if we can get those keys to line up. We may have to do some filing on that side of things. And we'll put a hardened bolt in there. I've got a couple of those here. So we'll put that hardened bolt in there. That'll keep that from spinning off of the bush hog. And then we'll just tighten these little springs down until it have enough tension to keep it all rolling.
Hardened.
And then hopefully, we'll be able to get some bush hogging done. Harvey, are you tearing up the deer?
Tearing up the deer and threatening Daisy.
It's like, this is my deer. Whoa, 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 whoa.
He's going to sneak up behind you and grab your tail.
Yeah, see? All right, friends. That's about all we got for you. We're going to go get the rest of this put together. Lord willing, get some bush hogging done. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you guys on the next video. I'm going to put the camera away now. Bye-bye.